Hey, is that the editor's office?
Okay. Murder, murder. Never something like it. Mo was the mouse knocked off. Peter the pooch rubbed out. Benny the buzzard missing. 30 years, man and boy in this newspaper game. I never saw nothing like it. Something's wrong. Police all doing the best. I don't know. Newspapers, radio. Most you hear, most you read is murder. Come in. Well, who are you? I'm a busy man. Speak up.
My name is Ted Simmons. I've been trying to get in touch with Munt.
They told my girl to keep you out of here. How'd you get in?
Well, I knew she had to go out sometime, and when she did, I walked in.
Just like that, huh?
Sure. I wanted to see you.
No wonder there's so many murders. What do you want?
A three-letter word. J-O-B.
Don't need no janitors, copy boys, or ink devils.
I'm a reporter.
A reporter? Where did you ever report?
Booker T University. But don't let that frighten you. I know a thing or two or three. Say, you must have read my column. I sent it to you every issue. Say, I know this nightclub racket from way back. Why, I've interviewed all the big shots, all the glamour gals, and...
That's enough. I need a reporter, but not one of your kind. The last guy I had here was enough for me. This was his first job. His name was Hal. He was popular, but foolish, hard-headed, knew it all. Instead of keeping his head and sticking to the job, he gets himself fascinated with a nightclub singer by the name of Lola. She was fooling around with a guy named Louie, a piano player. Nice guy, but too busy with his music to pick his women. This Lola was a bad one, all right. She was mixed up with a fellow by the name of Mike, Pickaxe. And he, of all people, had to break out of prison. I said to Hal as he went out that door, Hal, take it easy. Stick to your business. He did not. I sent him out on a simple story. Told him to go to Bill Smith's nightclub, stick around, talk to the people, and get the human interest. What did he do? Instead of getting the information that I sent him for, he went gallivanting with Lola.
The way I see it, honey, anyone with talent like yours is just wasting her time around that joint. Of course, you've got to be known first, but that shouldn't be too hard if you have friends who can help you. Supposing now my paper got interested in your, well, now someone on my paper thought that you had what it takes and wanted to help you get there. Pictures, art layout, something to catch people's eye. As a matter of fact, I know someone on my paper who could help you if you wanted to be friends. I look at it this way. To get any place, it takes friends and connections. Everybody knows that. Well, you've got the talent. All you need is the right connections.
You make everything sound so easy, Hal. I wonder just what the right connection is. Oh, I wanted to listen to the broadcast.
Baby, you're by the pool. Well, baby, be a
oh, I see. Now, you've got one of those television sets, huh?
What, hip in the jungle?
Hip? Look out!
Ow!
Since we all got hip, lost our saucer lip. Flip your lip.
Flip
your lip. Flip your lip. Flip your lip. Doll was out of place. Soup came into space. Flip your lip.
Flip
your lip. Flip your lip. Them swing cages was from above. Help this up to what we really are. No college of knowledge could ever disapprove. Mr. Livingston, my God, me, say we're in the room. I'm a cute little bangy from you, bangy. Bingy, bingy, bangy. Jack, I'm really telling you, nothing that this chick can do, you bangy. I'm a cutie bangy from you, bangy. Bingy, bingy, bangy, boo. When it comes to loving you, no telling what I'll do, you bangy. If you should go exploring and find things boring, then lift this bingy, bangy up. I'll make your tip a trip.
Sweating it out, you're running around with this dirty rat, Lewis. I break out of jail to see you, and you're running around with him. I'll kill him if I get my hands on him.
Still, those are both fog glass. Oh, Mike, honey, if you only knew how I wait for you those long, cold nights.
Well, there won't be any more nights like that for you, baby. You're coming with me. And make it snappy. The cops are looking for me right now.
I'll be ready in a minute, honey. Right where you are, he sees you, he'll kill you.
What's the matter, baby? You getting bashful all of a sudden?
Well, you know, after 2 years with no men around.
So Lewis wasn't here, huh?
Oh, Mike, honey. You know I wouldn't. You're just tired and jumpy, baby, that's all. You've been lonesome for your load, but you don't have to be anymore. You have her now. Now, just sit down and rest a minute while I finish dressing, huh?
See, that reminds me. I gotta get out of these clothes. A cop will take one look under this overcoat and I'm a dead pigeon. Got any idea where I can pick up a suit?
Say, I have just the place. Some fellow I know.
Oh, another one, huh?
No, honey, not that kind of fellow. He's married, but he has plenty of money. He owns the club I work at. His name's Bill Smith, and he's real friendly. If I just went up and asked, he'd lend me a suit for you. Give it to me.
He would, huh? Well, let's go see this Bill Smith.
Good, babe. I'll get my hat and coat in the hall.
Could be a nice story.
That girl Lola is a lollapalooza, isn't she?
Yeah, she's crooked as a barrel of worms. But she's smart, too. She has a lot of gall. You know, she even took Mike over to Bill's apartment intending to promote a suit of Bill's clothes for Mike to wear instead of that prison garb he's wearing. Bill was out, so they decided to come back later.
Smith? Bill and Mary sounds like two names on the register.
No, Bill Smith is his real name. I knew him 15 years ago. He was a decent fellow then. He was a detective. But the money was coming too slow, so now he operates nightclubs. He calls it Bill Smith Incorporated.
Yeah, I know his secretary. Gee, she's a swell kid.
An animal with three letters starting with A. What the heck could that be?
Oh. Bill Smith Nightclub Enterprises, Incorporated. Who's busy? What's busy? None of your business. Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Smith. Excuse me. Oh, yes, that was Mr. Jones. He kept me on the phone a half hour. Yes, sir. No, sir. Of course, sir. Oh, you won't be back? Tomorrow morning? You're going to a party? A masquerade? Oh, gee. Oh, excuse me. Oh, have a nice time.
Mr. Smith, please.
Who wants him?
Hal Ford, reporter.
All information given to the press is given out by press releases.
Say, sister, look, relax, relax. Nobody wants to interview your Mr. Smith. That much of a big shot. Besides, I've got something very important to tell him.
What?
Well, I'll tell you. There's somebody on their way over to his house right now who ought to be in jail instead. And Mr. Smith, being a former detective, you better know the kind of people he associates with.
Real gangsters? Gee, isn't that exciting? Why, it's just like the book I've been reading.
Come on. Where is he?
Oh, I don't know where he is. He went to a masquerade.
Where?
How should I know? He's probably there getting drunk now. Oh, sometimes he gets so drunk.
Oh, never mind. Just give me the address. I'll go over myself and see what I can... Gangster ought to be in jail and maybe leave Lola alone.
Lola, the singer?
Oh, never mind. Just give me the address. And say, you'd better stick around until you hear from me.
Oh, but I have a dinner date.
Well, go ahead, but you'd better come back right after. Something might come up.
But Bill wasn't at the club, so he rushes out to Bill's apartment to see what was happening.
Funny, that door being unlocked.
There was Hal, my dubious disciple of Horace Greeley, marooned in Bill's apartment while Bill was at a masquerade party sipping and dipping.
Getting high, huh?
Getting high? High as two Georgia pines. Man, don't you know that even I took a few too many there. Felt kind of good. You know, before I knew it, I was standing in front of the band singing up a breeze.
Nicest little masquerade party. How about a kiss in here?
Why don't you take off your mask? I know who you are, Mr. Smith.
Oh, you do?
Mr. Smith's going to play for us again.
Yeah?
to be happy when your skies are blue. Listen and I tell you then, there's just one thing to do. When dark clouds come your way, open up your heart and then say, hello, happiness, when you come on in. Hello, Mr. Happiness, where have you been? I was so blue and so low down, waiting just for you to come around. So hello, happiness in my heart you abide. Hello, Mr. Happiness, come on, stay close by my side. All my friends, I love you best. When I have you, I know I've got the rest. So hello, hello, Mr. Happiness. Hello, happiness in my heart. Bye. Hello, happiness, stay close by my side. Of all my friends, I love you best. I've got you, I'll keep the rest. So hello, hello there, Mr. Happiness. Hello!
Having a good time?
Oh, I'm having a wonderful time, Bob. Say, how about getting Noble Sissel for me? I'd like to have him for my club. Could you arrange it somehow?
Could I arrange it for Noble Sissel to be at your club?
Yeah.
Man, leave it to me. I'm solid with him. I'll fix that up for you.
Okay, Bob, I'm depending on you now.
Pay no mind.
Look at Bill. He's making a fool of himself. I'm going to take him home right now. Come on, honey, let's go. I have a headache.
Oh, I don't want to blow now.
Let's go.
Well, I wanted to come on over to the house and have a drink.
You probably bugged me out when I died.
Kitty. Kitty.
Stop the plate of milk and let him
find
it for himself.
Good idea. Gotta have your supper. Wanna make it?
Bill, where are you? Bill! Bill! Bill!
What a story.
Well, baby, you heard what happened. They won't be home for quite a while. I need a suit.
Hey, you! Really a good thing I came along. Just in time, too.
You don't, Papa.
Well, listen. Not 10 minutes ago, someone tried to rob your house. But I caught him.
Well, Papa, I'm mighty grateful to you. I wonder could you do me just one more little favor. It seems my keys are missing. Maybe those burglars found them. Could you climb through the window and open the door for us?
Why, certainly, Mr.
Smith.
Glad to oblige, Mr. Smith. Mrs. Smith.
Thank you.
The name's Jerry. Jerry O'Hare. Where's the light, Mr. Smith?
Oh, the light, right here on the wall.
Oh, here it is.
Well, everything seems to be in good shape, but you never can tell. Maybe we better take a look around before we leave, just to be sure that woman didn't take anything.
Well, everything seems to be all right. Guess we'll turn right in. Had a hard day today. We'll go right to bed, I guess.
Bad business leaving stuff like this around. That's how robberies happen. Carelessness, here.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, aren't you even gonna count it?
Well, it looked all right. It's all right, believe me.
Well, you never can be too sure about money. And this, bet that cost plenty.
No, that was a present from my boss.
Must be a pretty nice guy to work for if you can afford things like that.
He is, yeah, certainly is.
That Bill Smith used to be a nice guy. Yeah, I knew him when he was on the police force.
Over to Bill Smith's house. I've always wanted to see how he lived.
Come on, honey. Everybody else is getting in the act. I'm gonna do my number. Yes, sir.
It's too late, baby. I've got your double. It's too late, baby. You've caused me so much trouble. You took my love for granted, just as if you didn't care. I've got a brand new sweetie going to carry on from there. I don't mean maybe. My train is waiting. Toot toot. Goodbye, I'm gone. It's too late, baby. I've got your double. You've been nothing but trouble to me. Baby. double, it's too late, baby. You've caused me so much trouble. You took my love for granted, just as if you didn't care. I've got a brand new sweetie going to carry on from there. I don't mean maybe. My train is waiting. Toot-toot. Goodbye, I'm gone. It's too late, baby. I've got your double. You've been nothing but trouble to me.
Mike and Lola returned the bills. Hal was still hanging around watching. He saw Mike shed that prison garb and put on one of Bill's suits.
Attention, attention. Le Nation Unie, son réunion conférence. Et j'espère qu'y aller à l'éteron. La guerre, tout défense la mort. Ferez tout le monde pour la guerre. Toutes les toujours. Assez fini.
So do I, Count. As I was saying, Mike, assisted by Lola, pulled the wool right over the willing eyes of Jerry the cop.
Well, you've got plenty of talent, Jerry.
You think so, baby?
That must be your call, Jerry.
This is Patrolman O'Hare. Sure. He's here now.
We gotta get rid of this guy. It's getting late.
Leave it to me, baby, as soon as he finishes that call.
Okay. You tell him. Goodbye. Well, I guess that fixed things.
I hope so.
You want to hear the rest of that number now?
I'm awful tired. I should get my beauty sleep.
Me too.
You with those clothes on?
Oh, yes. We always dress for bed.
Guess you better make it some other time, Jerry.
Personally, I think that's very rude of us. After all, what Jerry did for us tonight. Play that song, Jerry.
Yeah, make it nice and loud, Jerry. I think I hear someone outside.
Many crooks call me.
Here's a number from my new show. Would you like to play it for me?
What key are you singing, baby?
Oh, B flat.
It's a good thing you're singing B flat, baby, because that's the only key I can play it.
Good deal.
Who's that?
Beat it.
It ain't right to love someone the way I love you like I do.
Listen, Bill ain't here. He went away and said he didn't want to see nobody tonight. Now, slam.
That don't love you. I can't help it if I love you.
Okay, you asked for it. Now, shut up, all of you. Do what I say.
I need to. It ain't right, but I can't help. Cause I...
Listen, you keep crying. That's you get the same.
It ain't right to love someone the way I love you like I do. It ain't right to love someone that don't love you. I can't help it if I love you and you're cheating on me too. It ain't right. But I can't help it, cause I do. I'll wash and dry your dishes. I'll clean and make your bed. I'll work and slave around you till my face turns cherry red.
Love it.
I can't help it if I want to work and slave to be with you. It ain't right, but I can't help it, cause I do. Take a course, Daddy.
Solid.
clean and make your bed. I'll work and slave around you till my face turns cherry red.
That's great.
I can't help it if I want to work and slave to be with you. It ain't right, but I can't help it, 'cause I do.
Okay, Count. Suspicion. Jealousy resolving in hate. We humans get into more trouble and sorrow in 1 minute than we can rid ourselves of in a lifetime. Bill thought Mary was cheating on him when he called from the police station and Mike answered.
None of your business. Who's this?
Where's Mary?
This is Vanderbilt 8316. And Mary won't speak to me, huh?
Not tonight, mister.
You wait till I get... I don't know.
Mary was certain that Bill was doing the same thing when she called and Lola answered.
Well, good night,
good
Jerry.
Night.
We
good
hope
night.
To see you again, Jerry. Hello? Is that any way to talk to a stranger? Doesn't want to talk to you.
Is it for me?
No, Jerry.
Well, nobody cares for an old cop. I guess I'll be on my way.
Well, okay, Jerry. I'll see you again. Come on, baby. Snap it up. We gotta go.
Honey, wouldn't you love to know?
Heaven only knows what's going on in my own house.
Well, that about does it. Oh, yeah. Just one thing more. Wait a minute, baby. I think this time the back door.
Imagine Bill Smith being grilled at the police station.
Gefella, gefella, the Krieg in Palestine, Jerusalem is grown, constant Persian and Lagarin and Cyprus, the Krieg is nicht arriba, the Krieg is nicht arriba.
Is that so?
Well, don't worry, Ted. That secretary of Bill's got him out of the clinker the very next morning. Quicker than you can say cottontail rabbit.
Bill Smith Nightclub Enterprises, Incorporated. Who? Hal what? Reporter? Oh, of course, yesterday, I remember. Say, tell me, what happened to that gangster? Did you go to my boss's house? You're still there? Why? Good heavens, Mr. Smith in jail? Why? What did he do? Did he kill the gangster? Now, isn't that silly? Well, I'll have to call him. What police station is he in? You don't know? Well, I guess I'll have to call them all then. Wait there, and I'll call you back.
Police headquarters, Sergeant Carter talking.
Do you have a Mr. Bill Smith there?
Who?
Say, who do you think you are? Putting people in jail for no reason whatsoever. Why don't you learn your business? Is he tall, dark, and kind of gruesome? Was he drunk? Well, that's my boy. Look, I'm telling you, he is Mr. Bill Smith, president of the Bill Smith Enterprises Incorporated. And if you don't release him immediately, I'll call the commissioner. Who am I? I'm his boss. I mean, he's my boss. I'm his secretary. Are you going to let him out or not?
All right, I'll let him out.
Oh, you dirty so-and-so. Wasn't enough for you to take my wife, you had to break my house, too.
Bonsoir! Au revoir! Au revoir, mon beau compatrie! Ma boss, excellent.
Goodbye, Count.
Hey, who in the world is that guy?
Him? He's our foreign editor. You know, Ted, a man and wife should never try to take it out on one another by making each other jealous. It leads to trouble. Look what it did for Bill and Mary.
Get the fellow. He might meet you at the door with a 44. You'll be drugging that, I know. Somebody's got to go. A G.I. Joe with a 44. Oh, please, that's the cheese. You got to squeeze.
That number.
And now, boss, our next number needs no introduction.
It's your own little Lola.
I'm sure you're gonna like this number, honey. You to help me. I have someone I'd like for you to meet.
Anything that'll make you happy, honey.
Mr. Smith, I would like for you to meet Mike.
Like your taste in clothes?
Yeah, thanks.
That's what I want to talk to you about. He was in a lot of trouble and had to change clothes awful fast.
Well, of course, the flower's your own.
Oh, yeah.
Let it fit. Go on back and enjoy the show.
Yeah. Hey.
Prison break, huh?
Thank you.
And now, Mr. Smith, here's the number that I wrote for your new show. Make it good, boys. The voice is out front. A one, a two.
Pull it. Lock all the exits.
A little investigation here. As a former member of the Detective Bureau, I insist that everyone stay until the police arrive. Now we'll see what happens. Nothing doing here. He's dead.
The police are just starting to investigate now. Yeah, it looks mighty bad for Mike.
There was Hal at the phone, getting ready to tell me who the killer was, when.
Enough is enough. Take him, Inspector.
Hat first.
Come on.
Bill, come on, give me the story. I'm holding the presses. My reporter just hung up on me.
How clever it was. Hal, your reporter, figured that by killing Louis, Mike being an escaped convict would be blamed, leaving the field clear for himself and Lola.
Oh, so that's how it was. Say, what happened with you and Mary?
Oh, that's a funny one.
Cheap home wrecker, sneak, and sympathy chiseler.
You jealous cat.
Jealous cat, you!
All right, come on, break it up.
Break it up,
break it up.
What do you think?
Break it up.
Break it up, what do you think?
Break it up.
This time you're going to spend more than a day in jail.
What are you talking about, officer?
Look, Mr. Smith, I know a bad egg when I see one.
But I was in jail myself last night.
And I thought you were with another woman.
And I thought you were with another man. Nellie, now I understand.
I don't understand a thing.